preachers not praying like they used to pray.
All right, now.
Amen. Worried about, amen, if I don't tell them the truth, I ain't gonna get no check.
Well.
But let me tell you something. Amen. I'm not worried about a check. Because I serve a God that is able to do exceedingly abundantly more than I can ask or think. And I want you to know, if I don't tell you the truth, your blood is required in my hand. Amen. I'm not fussing this morning, but I just want us to see what's really going on, because we're living in a world where, amen, God says, my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways. He said, then I will hear from heaven and do what? Heal the land. The next thing Jesus tells us about, and I got to move on, he said that there would be parasites. Amen. Would that mean an epidemic of disease? Amen. AIDS, amen, is rapid. Amen. Not only that, they got other diseases now that is taking over. You say, what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying that we got to be ready to meet the Lord at all times.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And so, amen, as we go on, Jesus tells us, amen, I come to tell you that if you're in Christ, no disease will overtake you.
Well, all right now.
Amen, the Bible said that you can take up poison, amen, if somebody trying to poison you, read the Bible. It's in the Bible, said that they can't poison you. The Bible said that, man, that, amen, Paul was stuck out on the island. And St. Paul got ready to build a fire. And the Bible said he reached down and grabbed some sticks. They called it kindling. And began, he was going to build a fire. But when he reached down there, amen, he didn't see the snake down in the midst of the stick. Amen. The Bible said that the viper, amen, the vomit, amen, licked to Paul's hand. Said, but that Paul didn't even swell, and the people around him, amen, thought Paul, amen, was a witch or a sorcerer. You say, what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying no deadly thing can harm you. I don't know about you, but I'm living to have that kind of power. Amen. I'm not faking and shaking. Amen. Because I want to see people change and delivered. Amen. I don't care. Amen. How many bologna sandwich I had to eat. Amen. I want to see people change and delivered. Amen. I come to tell you, amen, I hadn't had too many days of bologna yet, but it might get that way. You say, what are you saying, preacher? I'm trying to tell you, amen, that we got to be real with the Lord. Amen. Not only that, I come to tell you, amen, that we're living in the last days. Amen. Then he said, he goes on to say, amen, and then ye shall be delivered. First he said, this is the beginning, earthquake and devilish places. Earthquake and devilish places, and then I'm moving on. I didn't only look to see what earthquake was. I say, because I heard about 2 or 3 years ago we had some earthquakes in Arkansas. And so, I wanted to get some facts. And so I went and got some facts. Amen. In Arkansas, amen, in 2011, amen, we had 60 small earthquakes. The statistics shows, amen, that they were 1 mile, amen, from Greenbrow, Arkansas. That's somewhere on the other side of Conway. These are things that Jesus said will come to pass. In February the 17th, 2011, they had 3 more earthquakes. Amen. In a little town called Guy, Arkansas.
Yeah.
Amen. So what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying, amen, that prophecy is being fulfilled.
Yeah.
And it's time that we would get ready to meet him. Then it goes on to say these things will happen, because it tells us, amen, it says, amen, and you shall be killed and shall be hated of nations for my name's sake.
Yes.
Now some of you said this is not us, But when I come to tell you, you got other Christians and brothers in the third world country, I get this magazine and this email called, amen, I forgot what it's called. It's called the Martyrs Network, I believe it is. All right, all right. Amen, and people are being set on fire right now, today.
My Lord.
Amen, for naming the name of Christ. And those people that are leaders of those groups, some men are being castrated. Amen. For naming the name of Jesus.
Well.
Now the Bible says, amen, here that you will be afflicted, killed, and hate of nations. Amen. It was not talking about only us. It's talking about our brothers and sisters in third world countries where you're not even allowed to have a Bible. Amen. And some of us, we have Bible, amen, in our house, amen, and we don't pick it up to read it, and they can't even have a Bible.
Come on, preacher.
They're hiding in woods, amen, trying to assemble in the name of the Lord, and if they catch them, all of them are killed.
Well.
Amen. And we won't even come to Bible study, prayer meeting, amen, and stay 2 miles from the church.
Come on.
Amen. Some of us right down the road from the church. Amen. But that's the time in which we live in. And then it goes on to say, and many false prophets arise and deceive many.
Mm-hmm.
But this is what it said, because this is the problem. This is what I want you to see. And because iniquity shall abound and the love of many shall wax cold.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's the problem. Amen. We don't love like we used to love.
Yeah.
Seems like the more God gave us, the worse off we got. Amen. You remember, amen, when someone used to get sick, amen, you used to go in their house and, amen, you would cook for them, amen, and wash and do those things. But now, amen, we got beside ourselves. Amen. We don't remember where we come from. Amen. We don't worry about nobody but our three and no more. Good God Almighty, but he said the love of many will wax cold.
Mm-hmm.
We're living in a day, amen, amen, the church folk can't love one another.
Well.
Amen, we don't get along with one another, amen, because, amen, if somebody say something that hurt my feelings, amen, I ain't going back no more. But what I'm trying to tell you is we got to look beyond that. Amen. We got to start loving one another with that kind of love that God loved us with. He looked beyond our faults and saw our needs. Amen. And reason why, amen, a lot of our churches are not full. I'm talking about full with the right people. I ain't talking about those that full with the wrong people. I'm talking about those that full with the right people. Reason why? Because Jesus said, I didn't come to seek and to save that which was lost.
Yes.
Amen. Jesus, I came to seek and to save that which was lost. The reason why lost ones are not coming to the house of God, because we make them feel alienated. Amen. We want everybody to think we got it going on, but the fact of the matter is, I didn't come this morning because I had it going on. I come because it's of the grace of God that God reached down in a little town called Brookhaven, Mississippi. Amen. And called a little old preacher, amen, when he was 19 years old, that wasn't nobody. Amen. They told me I wouldn't amount to anything. But I thank God for my mama. But that's all right. If your mama told you you wouldn't be nobody, I come to tell you there's one that laid down his life for you. The Bible said there's no greater love than a man would lay down his life for his friends. It said no greater love than this. And so what I come to tell you is that love hides a multitude of faults. Amen. Quit putting down on somebody. Quit putting down on these young women because they don't dress like you dress. Put your arms around them and try to teach them how to dress. God Almighty. Quit, amen, putting down on young men, running women, because you used to run when you was that age. Put your arm around them, good God Almighty, and say, let me teach you how to be a man. Jesus said, with love and kindness, the church. When the church get it right, the world will get it right. This is why Jesus said, you are the light that setteth on a hill and cannot be hidden. The God Almighty. But I come to tell you, when you use the love of God, your light shines dim and dim. When you get caught up into yourself and think you've done something, you ain't done nothing. I used to say, amen, what I got, God gave me. What I am, He made me. What I am, He bought me. Amen. And what I learned, He taught me. Good God Almighty. You say, what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying that we got to get out of self. We're too full of self and not full of God. When you get full of God, you exalt your brother higher than yourself. Good God Almighty. When your brother is in need. And see, that's what's not going on in the church. You know what we do? We call ourselves Christians. But a brother or sister will be missing in action. Even in the military. When you go missing in action, or AWOL, baby, they coming to find you. The authority are going to look for you. But you know what? In the church, we messed up, Brother Robinson. Won't see one another for 2 or 3 months. Won't even pick up the phone and call. But we're talking about we Christians. But what I'm trying to tell you is we're going to have to get it right in the church. If you want your children to change, you're going to have to get it right in the church. Good God Almighty. I'm talking about that love that Jesus had. I'm not talking about an eros love, which is a sexual love. And I come to tell you, sex and money has got this world messed up. You know why? Because I come to tell you, not only is pornography one of the biggest interests in the world, but they didn't make all their money off worthy folk either. We just might as well keep it real. That's what's wrong in the church. When we, as leaders, go back to the Bible, this is why Paul said, when he thought he was doing good, Paul said, oh, wretched man that I am. Then I heard Isaiah say, your righteousness is as a filthy rag compared to Jesus. I come to tell you, I'm made of dust. If you don't believe you're made of dust, I dare you to get a white cloth and get a bath when you go home. You ain't been to work today, but I bet you get some dirt off your body. Man has got to remember that we're no more than dust. And so it's God that breathed into man's nostrils, and man became a living soul. And I just come to tell you, I didn't come out of shape, form, or fashion. But I come to tell you what is really going on. The problem is not with the world, it's with the church. If the church will go back to her first love, you know what I'm saying? The way you used to love God, when the old folk used to sing,